Hey guys, you are with the Tech Science. Today we discuss the point which are concerned with the chemistry, that is how to balance a chemical reaction. Generally, the chemical reaction, or it may be given in a word form, it may be directly given in a molecular form. So if it is given in a word form, you have to convert into the molecular form, and afterward you have to balance it. Now question is, what, why we have to balance the chemical reaction, or why we have to balance, always you have to write in balance form. Why? Of course, in the 9th standard we discuss a law that is called the law of conservation of matter, and in that law we have the statement, there is the matter which is present at the reactant site and at the product side, the matter is always constant. There is no rise, there is no drop, any kind of matter during the chemical reaction. So the total matter in a chemical reaction is always constant. On behalf of that, there is a protocol. We have to write a balanced chemical reaction. Now the question is, what, how to balance the chemical reaction, or what kind of like step you have to follow? Let's consider by taking an example of the chemical reaction. Generally in the 10th standard we have the chapter, in that one more like generally in the 9th standard also we have like a reaction, it is called neutralization reaction. In that case, when acid react with the base to form salt and water, and this reaction is called as the neutralization reaction. So let us consider one of the reaction, for example the sulfuric acid, that is called H2SO4, when react with the base like sodium hydroxide NaOH, it forms sodium sulfate Na2SO4 and water get formed. So directly here it is written in a molecular, in an equation format. It is called, the molecular formulas are given directly instead of word equation. Okay, now if you observe the reactant and the product, how many number of atoms are there, what is their number? For the reason, you have to draw a simple table. What is the name of the table? We have the elements, and these elements which are present on the left hand side, and total number of elements present on the right hand side. If you like maintain a table for that, it's very easy to understand how to balance it. Okay, now the elements which are present on the left hand side, for example hydrogen, sulfur, oxygen. So hydrogen second, sulfur third, oxygen. Here sodium we have one more, then sodium, next oxygen, it is already given, hydrogen it is already given. At the right hand side, sodium yes we have, sulfur we have, oxygen yes, as well as hydrogen oxygen both we have. So these are the number of elements which are present on the left hand side as well as on the right hand side. Now it's time to write down how many number of atoms are there in a particular compound or element. So number of element you have to count. For example hydrogen, here 2 plus 1, how many? These are the 3 on the left hand side. Regarding hydrogen, the right hand side we have the 2 hydrogen. Next sulfur here 1, sulfur is 1 on the left hand side. Right hand side we have sulfur, it is already 1. Okay, next oxygen, here 4 and here 1, 4 plus 1 5, so left hand side 5. Right hand side 4 oxygen plus 1 from the water, 4 plus 1 5, both are same. And sodium at the left hand side it is 1, and at the right hand side it is 2. So if you observe here, oxygen already balanced, sulfur is already balanced, am I right? So we have to balance either hydrogen and sodium. Now question is, what, how to balance? So from where exactly you have to start? Either you have to start the number of, maximum number of elements, maximum number of atom in a particular compound. Here we have Na2SO4 and NaOH. In that case we have maximum of elements, of elements are oxygen. Now it's time to balance sodium, because here oxygen is there, sodium we have, oxygen is there, sodium we have. So this is a compound which contain number of atoms in this compound is more, that's why it's very easy to start the balancing from those compound which have the maximum element and number of elements is also max. Okay, so suppose I have to start, for example sodium, at the left hand side we have, right hand side we have the 2 sodium, and at the left hand side we have the 1. So we replace it, we just place it here 2 NaOH, it is 2 NaOH. Now what happened here? There are 2 sodiums are there. Now I am replacing, observe here, I am changing, there are 2 sodium. But here afterward we have the 2 oxygen, and here plus 4, how many oxygens we have? We have the 6 oxygen. Hydrogen, there are 2 hydrogen plus, there are 2 plus 2 4, so here there are 4 hydrogen. Now somewhat there is a change. Sulfur is clear, sodium is clear. Now there is a change in hydrogen and oxygen. Again, if you have to balance it, which one? Hydrogen and oxygen. We have the compound H2O. So suppose we balance it by making, depreciating it with the 2. What happened here? 2 2s are 4. Hydrogens are 4. At the right hand side, left hand side, this is constant. These are the 2 plus 2, 4, it is already constant. And because of this 2, the oxygen also 2. So there are 2 oxygen plus 4. How many? 6 oxygens are there. Here already 6 oxygens are there. Now if you observe the left hand side element and the right hand side number of atoms, you got hydrogen 4, 4, sulfur 1, 1, oxygen 6, 6, sodium 2, 2. Now we can say that yes, this is a balanced chemical reaction, and this is what the today's point. Okay, so if any chemical equation, or it may be in word format, it may be in molecular format, you should be given. In that case, you have to write the elements, number of elements at the reactant side, number of elements at the product side, and just count number of elements from the left hand and number of atoms at the right hand, and try to balance with a those elements which have greater, like elements are there in a particular compound and how many atoms are there. So just start to balance the equation by using such kinds of technique. Okay, so this is what the today's topic. Thank you.